Christmas is a great time for family and friends, so we all met up to share what we'd uncovered about how we celebrate.
Oh, I think we beat the others to it, Geth.
You're right with that?
Yeah, it's a big one. Oh, wow, this is going to be great. This space is perfect.
It is. I'm feeling Christmassy now.
Oh, my gosh.
Don't you love Christmas?
Me too.
Do you think a corner's a good place for it?
Yeah.
Where did you get that from?
Well, it's funny you should ask, because there is a story behind that.
Love your stories.
Oh, let's decorate.
Around 8 million real Christmas trees are sold in the UK every year, and they come in all different shapes and sizes.
And many of them start life somewhere like this, a Christmas tree farm.
I've come to Dumfries in southwest Scotland, where they grow Christmas trees to buy online.
So how many trees have you got here then?
We've got about 250,000 here at any one time, Connie. And we're harvesting about 10% of that each year, about 25,000 a year.
That is a lot.
Well, in comparison to a lot of tree farms, it's not that many, actually.
What's this then?
Well, this is the machine we use to cut the trees down with, Connie. It's just like a big set of secateurs.
I thought you'd have some, like, massive machine to cut the trees. It's just like a lawnmower. How does it work?
Dead easy to use. This lever here moves it backwards and forwards, and that one works the cutting mechanism.
Is that it?
Yep, simple as that.
Stoke her up. Let's chop one down.
Thanks to the machines they use, Rory and his team can harvest 2,000 trees a day. And once they're cut, it's time to bag them up.
Put the trunk of the tree in the machine and hold that button. Simple as that.
I always thought that they were bagged up in a factory.
No.
It's clever to do it on the side. Wow. That nearly took my arm off.
Well, it's perfectly safe, Connie. In fact, you've done it so well, there's a whole line up here for you to do.
I asked for that.
On you go.
So, Rory, how was I?
Yeah, you did well, Connie.
Cool.
Maybe not quite as fast as some of the guys, but there could be a job here for you someday.
Oh, cheers. Can I pick a tree then?
Of course you can. Help yourself.
For thousands of years before the arrival of Christianity, pagan people held celebrations at wintertime. The main one of these was the winter solstice, which is the shortest day of the year. People would decorate their homes with evergreen plants like holly and ivy. Plants like these are always green, even in winter, so they were an important symbol of eternal life. It's thought that Christmas trees themselves have only been around for about 400 years. The tradition began in Germany with small tabletop trees, often decorated with sweets and fruit. Trees became really popular and larger in Victorian times. Prince Albert, the Queen's husband, was German, and he made sure the royal home always contained a Christmas tree. The royal family was very popular at that time, and the public always tried to copy the things they did. It wasn't long before the fashion of having a tree spread throughout Britain.
Oh, I loved it on the Christmas tree farm. It was so fun. And this fits perfectly. Hello.
Hi.
I didn't know.
It's a shame it didn't snow, though.
Oh, I tell you what, it definitely rained to make up for it. Oh, it was soaking wet.
You did a great job. This is a great tree. Right, what do you want? Angel or star?
Definitely star. That angel is scary.
You guys!
Hello! Merry Christmas!
I brought you some more decorations. Check this out.
Guess that? Where's the special guest?
Hey, it's all a surprise, all will be revealed later.
I've got a little surprise of my own in the meantime.
And I thought we'd like some hats.
So that you later.
Yeah, we're matching. And Andy,
yeah.
I thought you might like to be King Christmas.
Yeah, I like that. Nice one, man.
Gethin,
yeah. I got you the Santa.
Brilliant. Thanks. Do you know why this is perfect?
Why?
Because recently I've been training to be Father Christmas. Ho, ho, ho.